Hey guys, my name is Daniel Mudhaki and I'd like to thank you all so much for joining me today. Most importantly, I'd like us to thank God for enabling us to see a new day. I always remind you, be careful to give thanks to God when you see a new day, because a new day is a precious gift. A new day is a chance for you to become better than you were yesterday. A new day is a chance for you to forgive those who have wronged you. A new day is a chance for you to love more. A new day is a chance for you to become a better person. And so always thank God when you get that opportunity, because there are many who have not got that chance. You know, guys, this channel was started with the main purpose of making sure that we all grow and learn to understand that God created us all with a purpose. You know, there's potential that is put within you. And unless this potential is unleashed, then you will live a life without purpose. And so I thank God, because a lot of us have been learning from this channel, myself included. I thank you for all the feedback you've been giving me, and I pray that we'll continue sharing this word with many more people so that we can all get to a point where we will live purpose-filled lives. Guys, if you haven't subscribed to this channel and you're watching right now, what are you waiting for? Hit the subscription button and also remember the notification bell so that you are always alerted when we post a new video, which is normally every Sunday by God's grace. So guys, thank you so much. As I always do as well, before I forget, I leave my information at the bottom there. And so if you have anything you'd like to write to me about, any questions, any topics you'd like to suggest that we talk about, feel free, drop me an email, chat me on my social media pages, and I'll make sure to respond to each and every one of you. And so guys, new week, new video. You know, last week I was having a conversation with a friend of mine, and she asked me a question. You know, Dan, would God spare you? And that got me thinking. You know, if you read the Bible, there have been very many different times in this world that people have become so wicked that God has brought catastrophe upon man. If you read the story of Noah, you know, you'll realize that that time was a time when people had become completely wicked. You know, people were proud. Greed was at its highest levels. Idolatry was pretty high. Promiscuity, you know, all these ills that ensure that a society is completely destroyed while thriving in the time of Noah. And you see, God saw within that time that Noah was the only person who lived a righteous life. He was the only person who lived in accordance to what God had required. And God spoke to him and requested him to build an ark so that when he brought destruction upon man, Noah would be spared. Another story in the Bible also that we read is the story of Daniel. You guys remember when Daniel was thrown in the den of lions? That story to me is very powerful, because Daniel was in a foreign land where God had made him prosper, and he had been appointed as an advisor to the king and to government officials. You see, all he did was so good, and he prospered in so many things, that the king wanted to promote him to a very high position. But all the other people around him were jealous of him, and so they kept looking for things that they could put Daniel down with. Unfortunately for them, Daniel was very diligent. He was faithful in all he did. He was not corrupt. He was righteous, and he was a man of good standing. And so they sat down and realized the only way to get Daniel is by introducing a law that dealt with his God. Anything that brought him away from God, that would work. And so they went to the king and sold an idea that for the next 30 days, everyone would only worship the king. Obviously, when the king passed this, Daniel was found praying, because Daniel prayed 3 times a day. And so when they found him still praying, they rushed to the king and told the king, "This guy is not doing as you decreed. And nobody can go against your decree, not even yourself." And so the king's hands were tied, and he had to throw Daniel into the den of lions as consequence for not worshiping him. But as he did, the king told Daniel, "Daniel, I pray that your God will preserve you. Your God will spare you." We all know the story. After a whole night in the den of lions, Daniel was alive and well the next day. God spared him. You see, the way Daniel lived his life, the things he did, he was righteous before God. And even in times of trouble, God spared him. Another example, my brothers and sisters, is the story of the three guys we all know well, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These guys were also in a foreign land, but God had elevated them. He had put them up, he had grown them, and put them in good positions. However, a similar thing to what happened to Daniel was happening to them. They were meant to always bow down and worship idols, but they refused. And so when the king was told about this, he was so angered, and he went and approached them and asked them, "You guys truly have refused to bow down?" And they told him one thing, "My friend, if you ask us to bow down, we shall not. Even if you decide to kill us, then let it be so, because we believe that God will save us. But even if God does not come through for us, we shall not bow down." You know, these guys refused to compromise. These guys refused to align themselves with the current trending conditions. And for that, they paid the ultimate price. They were thrown into the fire, into the furnace. You know, the Bible says that that furnace was 7 times hotter than normal. But guess what? God spared them. As the king looked into the furnace, he saw 4 men and asked his advisors, "Didn't we throw 3 people into the furnace? Now there are 4. He called them out and told them, "Guys, get out. Your God has truly saved you." And from that day, the whole land was ordered to worship the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. God spared them. Guys, let's look at the story of Lot. You all know Lot found himself in Sodom and Gomorrah. You know, Sodom and Gomorrah was one of the most wicked, if not the most wicked city that ever was. I think even today. All right? Whatever was going on there completely angered God. And God had purposed in his heart to completely destroy that town. But you see, Lot was in that place. Him and his family. And God had mercy on him. God wanted to spare him. And God asked him to leave that place. And truly, he left. God spared his life, but destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. Guys, all these stories I've talked about, if you sync them together, you'll realize that these were very difficult times that these men were living in. They were living in times where people had become proud, people had become greedy, people had become corrupt, people had become promiscuous. Adultery was the order of the day. Promiscuity was the order of the day. People were selfish. Everything that mattered was themselves. Idol worship had got to the highest it had ever been. And all these things had annoyed God. And God had purposed to bring destruction to the people. However, there are people he spared. God spared Noah. God spared Daniel. God spared Lot. God spared Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And if you look at it, you'll realize that all these people I have mentioned lived their lives in a certain way. There were people who were loyal. There were people who were truthful. There were people who were just. There were people who were faithful to the Lord God Almighty. And my friends, if you look at the conditions that we are living in today, 2021, the world we are living in today has become a very complicated place to survive. You know, in the Bible it says that in the end of days, people will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, corruption, selfishness, greed. You know, all these ills that we are currently seeing in our societies today. Wars will come from each and every place because people will not want to be patient with each other. Aren't we seeing these things today? And so when I started this video, I told you, my friend asked me a question. Daniel, would God spare you? And today, I want to pass that question to you today. If God was to decide that the world today will be like that time of Noah, will you be spared? Will you get a slot in the ark? Will you be part and parcel of the people who God will want to spare and to use for future generations? You know, if you were to be thrown into a den of lions today, will God spare you? You know, if you're to be thrown into a furnace, as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego are, will you be spared, or will that be the end of you? You know, my friends, we have to remember that we must live lives that are truthful. We must live lives that are righteous. The scriptures talk about the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Kindness, peace, patience. Those are the things that we need to live and abide according to. We need to have love. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. It's not an easy thing to do, but I guarantee you, when you do it, then it gives you a beautiful life. And so that question I was asked keeps lingering in my mind. Daniel, will God spare you? Daniel was spared. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were spared. Lot was spared. Noah was spared. Will you be spared? And so I want you to look into your life today. Sit back and see. Dissect your day-to-day activities. Look at your friends. Look at the environment you find yourself in. Look at the habits that have held you captive from being the person you're meant to be. Look at the situations that have taken you away from God. And ask yourself, will God spare me if He was to bring destruction today? And I want you to amend each and everything that keeps you farther away from God. Each and everything that keeps you farther from God, I want you to identify it and to stay away from. Because God loves each and every one of you. And that's why He created you. That is why you are alive today. And He wants you to achieve your purpose. He wants you to live a life full of joy, peace, and happiness. But without Him, then this becomes a very difficult thing to achieve. And so, my brothers and sisters, I'd like to leave that video at that. But I want you this week to ponder on that question. Will God spare me? Look into your life and see what it is that can hinder you from seeing the glory of God. And so guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Remember to subscribe to the channel, hit the subscription button, not forgetting the notification bell so that you can always be notified when we upload a new video, which is each and every Sunday. Thank you guys. May the Lord bless you. May He keep you. Take care of yourselves and have a fruitful week. Until next time, goodbye.